Hi, and welcome to the video training of JavaScript. In this video training, we will be first discussing cookies, what are cookies, and then we will see how to use them in JavaScript. So what are cookies? Cookies let you store user information in web pages. Cookies are data stored in small text files on your computer. When a web server has sent a web page to a browser, the connection is shut down and the server forgets everything about the user. Cookies were invented to solve this problem, how to remember information about the user. When a user visits a web page, his or her name can be stored in a cookie, so that next time the user visits the page, the cookie remembers his or her name. Cookies are saved in name value pairs, like username equals John Doe. When a browser requests a web page from a server, cookies belonging to the page are added to the request. This way, the server gets the necessary data to remember information about the users. Okay, to implement and test JavaScript to use cookies, you need a laptop or a computer in any modern browser. Okay, let's see how to create a cookie with JavaScript. JavaScript can create, read, and delete cookies with the document.cookie property. With JavaScript, a cookie can be created like this: document.cookie equals username equals John Doe. You can also add an expiry date in UTC time. By default, the cookie is deleted when the browser is closed. So document.cookie equals username equals John Doe, and we are giving expiry date that expires equals 18th December Thursday 2013 12:00 UTC. To the path parameter, you can tell the browser what path the cookie belongs to. By default, the cookie belongs to the current page. So that to document.cookie equals username John Doe expires Thursday 18 2013 etc. Path equals landing page. Let's see this in action. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to do, go to the command line. Here we are going into our projects, personal projects folders, and JavaScript. And here I'm going to create a project directory that is called JavaScript. Or I would say cookies, because I already have the JavaScript folder. So that's understood. Let's set the permissions. Cookies. Now go to the cookies folder and I'm going to use this HTML file. Here I'm going to save script. And here we are going to save document.cookie. Equals username. I'm going to use my own name, instead of John Doe, and I'm going to set the expiry date of this to, let's say, Monday 20 Jan 2022. That's next year 12:00 UTC, and I'm going to set the path to /. Okay. Let's save this file, and now let's go to the project folder and run this. Personal projects, JavaScript, cookies, and I'm going to double click it, and let's see what happens. Okay. It has opened it. Has no output because we didn't show any output either. So if I go to console and I go to application, I can see the cookies folder here. And if you go to file, I don't see any cookie right here at the moment. And first open successfully is not here. Strings, no cookie will be broken. Let's see. let run this from the command line and let's see what is the let's make it like this. So this is empty. This is working because we don't have any HTML document. First, we need to define a proper HTML document to get the cookies working. It won't work by just adding the script tag. HTML file in your computer, the cookie thing won't work. It needs a web server to implement the cookies. So here we have the cookie, as you can see. Now if we run our program that we were looking at before, where is the slide? Sorry, here it is. So now we can set the username, expiry date and path. So let's do that. Expires equal Monday 22nd. Session and we have the path slash rd from the domain localhost, the rd is named. So you can also see the size of the cookie as well. Now you know how to create a cookie using JavaScript. Let's move on to next slide. Okay, how to read a cookie with JavaScript. We have seen how we can create a cookie with JavaScript. Now it's time to read a cookie from JavaScript. So let's do that. I'm just going to comment this because we have already created the cookie. Now we want to read it from the browser. So let x equal to document.cookie. There is a cookie in my browser with the key value username is password. Change a cookie with JavaScript. Changing a cookie with JavaScript is very simple. You just need to replace the existing cookie. So here I can say Imran and I can change the expiry to January 2022. Save this file. And if I run it, and I go to application, and here you can see it has created another cookie name of small node, and the expiry date is of next year. So if I want to replace the username, I need to delete that. So company dot cookie goes to username small not fun, and then have that. The old cookies will return with the expiry date. If I change the expiry date, it will be the old cookie. How to delete a cookie with JavaScript? Deleting a cookie is very simple. You don't have to specify a cookie value when you delete a cookie. Just set the expires parameter to past date. So if I set this to 2019 and save the file, run it again, you see the cookie Imran Khan is gone. And if I want to delete the cookie with the value of Imran Khan removed, save it and run it again, it's also gone. It's not gone yet because it has a session expired. A session means if I close the browser and open it again, the browser will be gone. The value of the username will be gone. So let's try it again. If we open the browser, the localhost rd.html, you see the cookie is gone because that was available till the session of the browser. Session means the working period, the time period the user is working, has spent time on the browser, on your website. So this way you can see how you can verify a user if he has come back to your website, and you can detect that he is the same user. Thanks for watching this video. Please do subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, you can reach me if you need any assistance. I'll be more than happy to reply back.